Welcome you for this discussion, sir. Today we are going to discuss the topic.
Okay.
Today we are going to discuss the topic verb briefly. Let us discuss the meaning, classification, and uses of the verbs. So, what is the meaning of the
Okay.
verb? Can you say something about the meaning of verb?
Okay, will be just a word, a grammatical word we use in English language to denote an action word. It's also a verb is also used to represent a state. So we call it a verb. There are different types of verb. Okay, it's a doing verb and a word reflecting the state. Okay.
So verbs are classified into two main categories, auxiliaries and main verbs. Again, auxiliaries are classified into two, primary auxiliaries and modals. So in primary auxiliaries, there are B5s, am, is, are, was, were, do forms, do, does, did, have, has, had. Models, can, could, will, would, shall, should, may, might, must, ought to, need,
Okay,
have to, dare,
among this
etc.
primary auxiliary. Okay. Okay, I see among these primary auxiliaries, there are different forms: be forms, do forms, have forms. Be forms are am, is, are present, and was, were past. And among do forms, do, does, did, we use do for with the plural subject and does with singular subject, and did is the past form of do, common with both the singular and plural. Again, about have forms, have, has, had. We use have in present perfect tense with a plural subject, and we use has with the singular subject in present perfect, and had common with both singular and plural to represent past. They are also used for possession. We'll discuss in detail later. And regarding this, will, would, shall, should, they are also come among these auxiliaries. Okay. Okay, let's go to these modals. Modals means they are the verbs reflecting the mood or mode of the speaker. They are not used as what like these amis are and these be do have forms. We use these modals to reflect, tell the mode of the speaker in what mode he speaks. Among these are may or can, could, will, would, shall, should, may, might, must, ought to, need, have to, dare. Okay, can is present, could is past, will present, would is past, shall, should, may, might. Okay, we'll discuss in detail in future. Okay.
Okay, and then these are the main verbs, verb 1, verb 2, verb 3, and verb ing, and verb yes form. So this chart, this a tree, verb tree, verb class, it shows verb classification, and then uses of auxiliary. Uses of auxiliary is very important. Okay, can you add something to
Okay.
this?
Wait, see, auxiliaries are very important in English language. They're almost skeleton of this English grammar. Okay. We use auxiliaries to make sentences with main verb in different tenses. Take for example, there's a verb eat. If you just say eat, it is of no meaning, no clear meaning. So to make it a clear meaning, we use helping verbs like I am eating, you are eating, she is eating, I was eating yesterday morning, she was eating. Like that. So to make a sentence in a meaningful way, we use auxiliaries. So very important in making sentences with main verbs. Okay.
For example, I am speaking, that is present
Yeah,
continuous.
it's present. Yes. Yes.
I was speaking, that is past continuous. I will be speaking,
Yes.
that is future continuous. The only changes
Yes.
we find there, that is auxiliary. Okay. Second one,
Yes, yes.
it helps to frame question tags. So can you add something to this?
Okay, see, auxiliaries are very important in making tag is a short question added at the end of the statement. Okay, take for example, he is playing tennis is a statement. Isn't he? Is a question tag. Okay, one thing you have to note here, if the statement is positive, the question tag is negative and vice versa. He isn't playing tennis, is he? So auxiliaries are used in adding question tag to a statement. Okay.
Okay. And to form negatives also, we use auxiliaries to form negatives.
Yes, auxiliaries are very important in making negatives. Take for example, it is indefinite meaning sentence. He eat. Okay. He, but just by adding not, we cannot make it negative. He not eat is meaningless. So we use auxiliaries to make a negative sentence clearly. He doesn't eat. He doesn't eat. He eats 10 idlis. No, no. He doesn't eat 10 idlis.
Yeah.
Like that. So to make negative sentences, auxiliaries are very important.
And also to frame questions, we use auxiliaries.
Oh, making question, yeah. See, to make question, without auxiliaries, we cannot make questions at all.
Yes.
Okay. Take for example. Eat. Do eat. Example. In many people, what happens that they do not begin the question with auxiliaries to make question. You are fine. See, that's a statement, not a question. Most of us in spoken English means you are fine. No, no, that is not a question at all. Begin the question with auxiliary. Are you fine? Do you eat? Okay. What were you at home yesterday night? Like that. Begin the question with auxiliaries. That gives you clear confirmation question. And also, you can make a double H question with the help of these auxiliaries. So use double H word plus auxiliary plus. You can add anything to it. Example, eat idlis. Do you eat idlis? Why do you eat idlis? Where do you eat idlis? With who did you eat idlis? Like that. So these auxiliaries are very important. They are unavoidably used in making questions.
Yeah.
They are very useful in framing questions. Okay.
Yeah. And also we use them in short answers, while giving short answers. Do you play tennis?
Okay. Short answer. Take for example. Yeah. See, many times what happens? You play tennis? No. Do you play tennis? The question response can be I don't play tennis. In many times you need not respond in full sentence. You just give a short answer. Do you play tennis? No, I don't. Do you play tennis? Yes, I do. There we use these auxiliaries. Do, don't. Are you okay? Yes, I am. You need not say yes, I am okay. No, not necessary. Are you okay? Yes, I am. Like, okay.
Okay.
Let's go ahead.
Okay. Now we can go to main verbs. Verb one means it is a base form. Simple present. So can you add some examples, one or two usages to this?
See, Yeah, see, base form is usually the very basic form of verb is called V1 or present form of a verb. We use them in different purpose. Take for example, expressing routine activities. I go to school. I eat breakfast. I go for a walk. We use to express our daily routine activities. We use only present simple form of a verb, that is V1. And okay, regarding this narration, have you narrated a film to your friend? There we use present simple. Take for example, see in the film, what happens? The heroine walks in the park. At the same time, a villain comes and attacks the heroine. He tries to kidnap the heroine. At the same time, the hero comes and fights the villain and takes his heroine. Okay, here, even it is the past action, we use present simple for narration. Okay.
And also in the sports commentaries also we use the same thing. It's like present narration.
If you watch, if you watch cricket commentary or volleyball, anything, they use only present simple. Okay, now the bowler comes, the bowler takes the ball, he throws the ball, and the batsman hits the ball, and the ball runs towards the boundary. Oh no, it crosses the boundary. It's a four like that. It's simple, very simple, present simple. They use in giving commentary.
And then it is used
Yeah.
that is planned future. Planned future. Simple present verb form, verb one form is used to express planned
Yeah,
future also.
yes, we use V1 or present simple form to express our planned future meaning. Take for example, next Monday, I go to bus stand. Then I catch the bus. I travel, I try to reach your home by 6:30. If it is not possible, I reach at least by 7:50. Actually, it's a planned future. So there also we use present simple to talk about the planned future.
And also in universal truths, we use simple present form.
Yeah, to express universal truths, we use only present simple, not any past or ing form. Take for example, the sun rises in the east and the sun sets in the west. It rains a lot in our Malnad area. Okay, see, it winds a lot. It rains a lot, and also the river flows, water flows downwards. Like that, universal truths are even in proverbs also. We use only present the simple. See, there are very many uses of this present simple. We need to be aware of it. Yes.
Next one is V2, that is past form to express past actions or past narrations or
Yeah.
past routines. One or two examples can you add this to this?
Okay. V2 is simple past. We use this simple past to talk about any simple actions that are just done before present. Take for example, I just went home and I sat down and took a cup of tea. Very simple. Also, you can use them to express your past actions, your routine activities. Yesterday, I got up early. And then I washed my face and took a bath. Then I had tea. I read newspaper. Then I went to my office. See, very simple past we use to express our past actions. Yeah.
Next one is verb 3, that is past participle. Normally we use it as in perfect tenses, and in passive voice we use the same past participle. Sometimes we use as an adjective also. So one or two examples can you give
Yes,
me?
see V3 means the students should know each verb has three forms. Okay, present simple V1, past simple V2, and past participle V3. Okay, some verbs are regular. We use ED. Take from work, worked, worked. Some irregular verbs have three different forms: eat, ate, eaten. Eat is V1, ate is V2, eaten is V3. But please remember that we use this V3 or past participle always with have, has, had. We do not use individually. Okay, take for example in present perfect. I have finished my homework. I have finished my homework. Have you eaten breakfast today? Okay, there we use have, has, plus V3. I eaten breakfast today. It's wrong. So always use have, has, plus V3. Okay.
The second one is passive. We use it in passive form.
Okay, you always remember that in passive forms, we use V3. We do not use neither V1 or V2. Always we use V3 in passive form. Take for example, I send the letter. The letter is sent.
Yeah,
I ate 5 idlis. 5 idlis are eaten. 5 idlis have been eaten. Okay. Always use V3 in passive.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then as an adjective, for example, written answer. So answer is noun.
Yeah.
Written answer. Written is an adjective.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, we use this V3 form as an adjective also, as you said, written answer. Worked example, painted wall. We don't think that painted wall is past tense. Wall is noun. What is used in third form before the noun is adjective. Painted wall, constructed building, answered questions, like this.
Okay.
Just have a point. Okay,
okay.
Fine.
Okay. And then verb S form, that is simple present. Verb S form, that is used with third person singular. So, can you add one or two examples for this?
Yeah, see, it is very, very, very important that in present simple, we use VS. VS means verb. We use S with the verb in present simple only when the subject is singular. Take for example, I eat breakfast every day. My brother eats breakfast every day. My mother wakes up late. My father goes to work. See, it is used in present simple with subject is singular. So always remember, in present simple, if the subject is singular, we use S with verb. He comes and goes. The train arrives late today. The clock clicks. See, the subject, you should do very, it's very important for you the sub to know the subject is singular, plural. Many times what happens, we unknowingly use, and sometimes we do not use yes appropriately. The clock click. The clock clicks. Train arrive late. The train arrives late. Okay, yeah. Fine.
Okay, right. And then this verb ing.
Okay, ing is very important in using in making sentences to reflect continuous tenses and ongoing action, to describing an ongoing action. Take for example, I am speaking now. You are presenting now. It is raining now. It was raining yesterday. Okay, you were reading newspaper yesterday morning. We use in present continuous tense. It is very important to use of ing.
Yeah.
Okay.
For all continuous tenses, we use ing form with auxiliaries.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And
yes.
Then it is used as noun form, that is called as gerund. For example,
yeah,
swimming is good
swimming,
exercise.
yes.
Swimming is good exercise. Here,
Yeah.
the swimming, that is ing form, that is used as a noun form. It is not a continuous form. It is a noun form that is called gerund. Okay. And then,
It's a very important for the students that they should know whether it is continuous or whether it is a gerund. Many times what happens, they I am swimming, I don't know swimming. He is smoking, smoking is dangerous. So no, here in gerund, helping verb come after the ing form. Smoking is not good. In continuous tense, helping verb come before ing form. Example, he is swimming, he is dancing. In gerund, dancing is very easy, swimming is not easy. See, very simple. Okay.
And it is used as an adjective also. So one example I can give. For example, running water, running water, running water.
Yes.
Here, it is used as adjective. And walking
Yes,
stick.
in walking, see, many times the students might confuse it. Walking stick is walking? No. It's just an adjective used to use is to reflect a continuous state of the action. Walking stick means it is a stick used with a walking man. Just a stick does not walk. So walking stick and acting prime minister. Acting prime minister means when the prime when the real prime minister is away, he is in charge of the premises, acting prime minister. The prime minister is not acting like in movies. Acting prime minister, acting president, like that. Walking stick, running water. What does not run, but it's to give the meaning of water is flowing. We say running water. Yeah.
And last one is it is used as an adverb. One example like this. She came dancing. She came dancing. Yeah. Here, dancing is used as an adverb. Came dancing like that. So it describes the verb
Yeah,
there.
so say,
That's why that is adverb.
yeah. ING is also used as linking verbs. See, knowing the answer, I sat quiet. Knowing the answer, I sat quietly, like that.
And
Okay,
then,
fine.
so it's better to give some idea about these two concepts, time and tense.
Okay.
Time and tense are two different concepts. Time is a concept. It can be divided into three: present, past, and future. The term tense stands for verb form used to express time relation. In English language, the English language has two tenses, namely the past and non-past. There is no future tense form of verb. There is no future tense form of verb. So, time and tense do not mean the same thing. There is no one-to-one correspondence between the forms of the verb and time. Look at these sentences. I am going to buy a new car. I am going to. That is present continuous, but it shows future intention. Future intention. Be going to. One structure is there, be going to, that is future intention. Be means am, is, are, was, and were. Second one, she goes to office at 9:30 every day. Goes, that is simple present, but the action happens every day. He is leaving for New Delhi next week. He is leaving for New Delhi next week. He is leaving. That is present continuous, but the action had to take place. Prime Minister visits our village next month. Here the verb is in present, but it shows the future action. The sun rises in the east. Rises is simple present, but it is universal truth. So that's why we say there is no one-to-one relation between time and tense.